Complications of varicose veins. All complications related to varicose vein are related to venous hypertension. And in the etiology, we said that obstruction of the deep system and the very high venous hypertension, as we said in the pathology, related to secondary varicose vein. Therefore, all the following complications are much more common with secondary varicose vein and less commonly and mild affection in case of primary varicose vein, because in primary varicose vein there is a slight mild increase in the venous pressure and venous hypertension is minimal. First of all, edema. Sure, in case of varicose vein, there is high venous pressure leading to impairment of absorption of extracellular fluid, and venous hypertension lead to accumulation of extracellular fluid, which is edema. Sure, in secondary varicose vein, the high venous pressure will produce marked severe edema, while in primary varicose vein, just a mild edema occur. In varicose vein, there is high venous pressure, and the pressure gradient between the arteries and the veins decrease. Due to decrease in the pressure gradient between arterial blood pressure and venous pressure, the blood flow from arteries to veins decrease, leading to impairment of tissue perfusion, tissue hypoxia, and accumulation of metabolites. Metabolites leading to capillary and venular dilatation. Dilatation of these venules and capillaries leading to rupture, release of blood in the subcutaneous fat. Release of blood in subcutaneous fat, the red blood cells disintegrate, leading to release of hemosiderin, which has brownish coloration, leading to this pigmentation. Hemosiderin is irritant material, leading to sense of itching, and repeated itching leading to dermatitis. This condition is called eczema. Therefore, pigmentation, itching, and eczema due to hemosiderin in the subcutaneous tissues. And the chronic dermatitis is called eczema. Due to capillary dilatation, the intercellular space between the endothelium becomes white, which permit perfusion of fibrinogen from the lumen of the capillaries to the extracellular fluid and to a subcutaneous fat. Fibrinogen in the subcutaneous fat will transform to fibrin. Fibrin will be fibrosed, and therefore the subcutaneous fat becomes replaced by tough fibrous tissue. This condition is called liposclerosis. We all know that liposclerosis. Lipo means fat, and sclerosis means fibrosis. Therefore, replacement of lipo, subcutaneous fat, by fibrous tissue is called liposclerosis. Therefore, in patient with secondary varicose vein, this is very, very rare to occur in primary. In secondary varicose vein, the subcutaneous fat becomes thickened due to the position of fibrin. by and replacement of subcutaneous fat by fibrous tissue. Fibrous tissue, therefore, the subcutaneous fat becomes a mass of fibrous tissue, tough, indurated, with pigmentation and eczema. These condition of pigmentation, eczema, and liposclerosis usually progress to ulceration. Venous ulcer. Venous ulcer is very important because it represents 90% of chronic leg ulcers. Why leg ulcers occur? Leg ulcers usually occur here, just above the medial malleolus, in the medial aspect of the lower part of the leg. Why? This is characteristic for post-phlebitic limb. Post-phlebitic limb, after DVT, there is high venous pressure in the deep system, leading to incompetence of ankle perforators. Here, the skin above the medial malleolus is drained by what is called the ankle perforators, which drains the skin here directly to the deep system. Therefore, very high pressure after deep venous thrombosis, and here in the lower part of the leg, the pressure is the highest pressure, will be reflected on the ankle perforators, leading to high venous pressure in this skin. High venous pressure in this skin leading to decreased pressure gradient between arteries and veins. Blood flow from arteries to veins is markedly impaired, leading to tissue hypoxia, impairment of nutrition of the tissue, and liberation of oxygen radicals toxic to the skin and subcutaneous fat. And the condition usually ends by ulceration. In addition to pigmentation and the eczema here, leading to itching, which may precipitate the ulceration. Therefore, the direct cause for this area, which is called the ulcer-bearing area, is incompetent ankle perforators, leading to the subsequent results: decrease of blood flow from arteries to veins, tissue hypoxia, impairment of nutrition of the tissue, devitalization of the skin and the subcutaneous fat. Actually, usually combination of venous hypertension with eczema and liposclerosis, ending by ulceration, either spontaneously or after minor trauma. Usually minor trauma is itching. What's the complication of this ulcer? Please palpate this area just above the medial malleus in your leg. Here, the skin on the periosteum of tibia. Tibia here is subcutaneous. Therefore, any ulceration, this is chronic ulcer leading to infection in the ulcer. And the infection lie on the periosteum of tibia, leading to periostitis. Periostitis is very difficult to be treated, leading to chronicity of the ulcer. For any ulcer or any wound to heal, we need complete sterile tissues, good arterial flow, good venous drainage, good lymphatic drainage. Are these factors present in this ulcer? This ulcer is infected with periostitis. And this ulcer, the arterial flow is good due to decreased pressure gradient between arterial blood flow and venous pressure decrease. leading to decreased blood flow from arteries to veins, and there is tissue hypoxia, and there is impairment of nutrition of tissue, which make healing is nearly impossible, leading to chronicity of this ulcer. I ask a patient about the duration of his ulcer. One patient tell me that the ulcer is present from 22 years. Chronic ulcer, 22 years. Neglected ulcer without treatment and the infection with irritation. We all know that chronic irritation usually end by malignancy. Therefore, squamous cell carcinoma may occur in this ulcer, a condition called the marjoline ulcer. Marjoline ulcer is squamous cell carcinoma on top of any chronic ulcer. Therefore, when occur on top of chronic venous ulcer due to irritation, the condition is squamous cell carcinoma called marjoline ulcer. Diagnosis of this ulcer is very easy. First of all, the characteristic site in the ulcer bearing area, which is drained by ankle perforator, just above the medial malleolus or the medial aspect of the lower part of the leg. Beside the characteristic skin changes around pigmentation, eczema, and liposclerosis, plus presence of secondary varicose veins. This is characteristic for venous ulcer. And the ulcer is usually chronic and very difficult to heal. May heal, but after healing, it is very liable to recur again. Treatment of venous ulcer mainly elevation. High venous pressure here is the cause. Therefore, just sleep in bed and elevate the lower limb to decrease the venous pressure. The most important item for MCQ in the treatment of this patient is elastic stocking. Why elastic stocking? To compress the vein, prevent regurgitation of blood from the deep system to superficial system, and to improve venous drainage from distal to proximal. Just decongestion of this area and lowering of blood pressure by elastic stocking and elevation, usually the ulcer heal. Besides, we should treat infection at present by antibiotic. Dressing of this ulcer is just saline dressing. Antibiotic locally is not recommended at all, because antibiotic treatment usually in this ulcer leading to allergic reaction and more itching, leading to more chronicity. Therefore, just saline dressing without any local antibiotic. There are some drugs we may help healing, as trintel, which improves the microcirculation, prostaglandin E1, and diazamine. Diazamine, prostaglandin E1, trintel improve microcirculation and may improve the condition of healing. Under this treatment, usually the ulcer heals within a few weeks, but when return to the normal activity, return to his work, return to prolonged standing and sitting, usually the ulcer recur again. What is the radical cure of this ulcer? Treatment of the cause. If there is repeated recurrence of the ulcer, resistant ulcer, incompetent ankle perforator should be treated. How? As we will take in the treatment, this ankle perforator is very easy to be injected sclerotherapy. Injection sclerotherapy by foam or obliteration of these ankle perforators by endovenous thermal ablation. Endovenous thermal ablation will be taken later on in the treatment. Also in this ulcer, hemorrhage may occur either spontaneous or after minor trauma. How to treat hemorrhage from varicose vein? Just elevation. Decrease venous pressure. Veins becomes collapsed. Bleeding stop. And the compression bandage. Elevation stop bleeding and the compression bandage is enough. And later on, sure treatment of varicose vein. Also, as a complication of varicose vein, periostitis. As a complication of venous ulcer. Marjoline ulcer, which is malignant transformation. This is a squamous cell carcinoma due to chronic irritation in venous ulcer. Finally, superficial thrombophlebitis. Why? In varicose vein, the superficial veins are congested and there is a stasis of blood flow, slow circulation in any site, in any blood vessel, leading to thrombosis. Therefore, in the superficial veins, the varicose vein becomes thrombotic, thrombo. Why it is called the phlebitis? Even if there is no inflammation, it is called the phlebitis because it occurs in diseased vein. Diseased vein, varicose vein. Therefore, due to a stasis of blood flow in varicose vein, the end result is superficial thrombophlebitis. It is called superficial because it occurs in superficial veins. Thrombus, phlebitis in diseased vein, which is varicose vein. Therefore, it's called superficial thrombophlebitis. Therefore, the complications of varicose vein, which is much more common in secondary varicose vein, are edema, pigmentation, eczema, liposclerosis, ending by ulceration, hemorrhage, periostitis, malignancy and marginal ulcer, and superficial thrombophlebitis. These are complications of varicose vein. Thank you for good listening and good luck.